Yeah, I wanted to, you discuss in the Golden Doves in chapter 4, the different levels of textuality. Mm-hmm. So for example, the Torah Shebichtav includes Torah, Nevi'im, Ketubim, and it also has the Megillot, such as Megillat Esther. Mm-hmm. So the, so there's different levels
of textuality.
So for example, we have the Chumash from Moshe Rabbeinu. So it's a written document. It could be read, nitana likrot, nitana lidaresh. That's the highest level of textuality. Then let's say you have the Nevi'im. The Nevi'im, you cannot make a derasha halacha. It can't be a source of midrash halacha, for example. And so on and so forth. So there's different levels of that. Then of the Megillat Esther, you have the machloket between Rav and Shemuel. Is it Igeret, not Igeret? What's the exact status of Megillat Esther? So, in that context, I thought it would be interesting. I was at a wedding last night, and I don't like just sitting down and doing nothing. So I was reading a very interesting Rabbeinu Se'adiah Gaon on the end of Perashat Mishpatim, right? The Pasuk says, "V'hat-Torah v'ham-mitzvah asher katavti lehorotah." And on this Pasuk, Rabbeinu Se'adiah Gaon had a fascinating commentary regarding the different levels of the Torah Shebichtav. So I will, with your permission, read it. Right. Im nabo lehosim mitocha hakdamot hare omedet perosh varishona ha-hashkafa shekol kitve ha-kodesh hem min ha-shamayim divrei Elohim.
Yeah.
Right. Now, but hakdamot here, I think he's referring to the Talkin, the traditions of the which I like, because you can't read the Torah Shebichtav, you know, in the abstract. It has to
be. Also, we don't have to forget, we should not forget, that before we had the Torah Shebichtav, there was Abraham, Isaac, and Yaakov. And therefore, they frame our mind.
Right.
And therefore, this mind organization, which was come from Abraham, Isaac, and Yaakov, is not written in the Torah.
Right.
It's pre-Torah.
Right.
Yes. Right. So in that sense also the Geonim say that the Torah Shebe'alpe kodeme the Torah Shebe'ktav.
Right.
Without this specific Torah Shebe'alpe, the Torah Shebe'ktav would be incomprehensible to us.
Right.
So when God gave us the Torah Shebe'ktav, He knew our frame of mind, the mindset of Am Israel.
Right.
And accordingly He gave the Torah. What happened with different culture? What happened is that the Torah Shebichtav is not for that culture.
Right.
Because God programmed the Torah Shebichtav to the mind of Am Yisrael.
Right.
The Torah Shebe'alpe of Am Yisrael, who we see from Abraham, Isaac, and Yaakov.
Right.
Yes.
And what he says here is that the hakdamot, or the starting position, is shekol kitve hakodesh hem min hashamayim dibrei Elohim. Bidragot Shanot, all of the Kitvei HaKodesh are from the Shamayim and the words of Hashem. But there's different levels. There's different levels of Nebuah, and there's different levels of Kitvei HaKodesh as well.
Yeah. Now, Tzedeha, when you say, and this is what I really honestly believe that all these commentaries and so on, and the philosophy of Jewish, whatever it is, nonsense, because they are just copying theology. Torah Min HaShamayim is not a theological concept. It's a legal concept, and therefore we should not in any way, because once that you say believe in theology, you're a pagan, because theology was invented by pagans before Christianity, and then the Christians adopted. Just like the word religion. Religion is a Christian term. There is no word religion before Christianity. So whatever we are, we're not a theological system, and we are not a religion.
Right.
It's very important.
Yes.
So Torah Min HaShamayim, yes, whatever it means, I know what does not mean. It doesn't mean theology, it doesn't mean religion.
Right. I want to loop back to something I spoke about a moment ago, about the Torah, and what we read here, that there's hakdamot to the Torah, meaning we are part of a tradition, Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, and the Chachamim say, Goy she'asak b'Torah, hayav mita. And they say, why? Torah Sivalanu Moshe Morasha Kehilat Yaakov, Al Tikve Morasha, Ela Meorasa, meaning that if a goy reads the Torah, it is akin to rape. Now,
how do you say rape in modern English? Biblical criticism,
right?
Or the stupidity of the so-called rabbinic sermons.
Right.
Yes.
I think that any approach to the Torah, which doesn't start with this, namely, the Torah is a legal document given by Hashem to Am Yisrael, is automatically.
And this Am Yisrael already, because very, very important, yes? And I learned this from Rabbi David Nieto, a paragraph of David Nieto in the Spanish, you know, Rabbi David Nieto. In the book of Shitan, it says, well, Yom Adonai Moshe Lemor Beshit Barai Elohim Tzachon
Ta'aris.
Right. So, people like Yehuda and others say that Bereshit involves a Chaldean from the Babylonia. And this is coming from Abraham Avinu.
Right.
Therefore, you know, Babylonia. So now, and then say Bereshit Barai Elohim Tzachon Vayom Hashem El Abraham. So this is the mind of the Hebrews before Matan Torah.
Right.
That's why in the whole history of Judaism, nobody contested Bereshit Barai Elohim. No, maybe somebody else. Even at the time of Korah. Korah never contested Bereshit Barai Elohim Tzachon Ta'aretz. Yes? Vayom Elohim Ye'or, etc. Never this was contested.
Right.
This was and is the foundations of the Hebrew mind.
Right.
Bereshit Barai Elohim Ta'aretz. You don't believe in it? No problem. You, Jews, they're not the only people in the world. But don't come and bother us.
Right.
Yes? I mean,
Don't
try to sell us your wares.
Right.
Yes?
Yeah. Right. Okay. And now he begins to analyze the highest level, which of course is the Torah that we received from Moshe Rabbeinu. V'sefer HaTorah erko yakar me'od u'madregato nisea ad shelo yidemu ela she'al sifrei ha'nevi'im. So you have the Chumash that is at the highest level, and then everything else is lower automatically. And that of course is by virtue of the fact that Moshe Rabbeinu himself was not a Navi. He was something above Nevoah.
It was Shariah Hashem. But it was a Shariah, not only Shariah Hashem, that's very, very important. It was also Shariah Am Yisrael.
Right.
So was on the one hand, he could represent us to Borei Olam, and then he could represent Borei Olam to us.
Right.
That's very important.
And therefore, whatever was given to Moshe Rabbeinu was Peh El Peh Adaber Bo. So that's one level of textuality, where you can make derashot, and more importantly, you can make legal derashot on the pesukim of the Torah.
I want to say something about Peh El Peh Adaber Bo.
Right.
I think this is very, very important. Adaber Bo. Bo. What does it mean, Bo? Peh Adaber Bo. In the Torah, there are only consonants.
Right.
There are no vowels in the Torah.
Right.
Some of the fact, if you put a vowel in the Torah, the Torah is Sefer Torah is Pasul.
Yes.
There's a ayot to what I'm going to say, that if the Sefer Torah, you put vowels, and then you erase the vowels, the Sefer Torah continues Pasul. You cannot, if I add an extra ayot, it's Pasul. But if I erase it, it's Kasher. Mm-hmm. But if I put the vowels,
and then you erase it,
it's Pasul. So I deal with it, and I think in the Golden Dawson or something. But anyhow, it's very important. Why? The Sefer Torah cannot have vowels. Because the Sefer Torah was written in consonants, given in consonants, and was assumed that we receive it, we are the second person, and the second person puts the vowel. So the Sefer Torah is only consonants, it's not for everybody. It's for a public that could provide the vowels. And we provided the vowels, giving meaning to the consonants. It's very important. So it's not just first person speaking in a vacuum is meaningless. First person to be meaningful has to speak to a second person. We are the second person. And how are we the second person? Because our collective mind and individually, we provided the vowels to incomprehensible to humans, the consonants.
Right.
It's very, very important. This is the idea of, I think, my golden doubts, yes. Yeah. Now, the goal. Yes, when he wants to rob the Torah, you know, the Christians, which are the biggest robbing in the world, the Torah, let them provide the vowels, yes, to the consonants.
Right.
All right? Let them provide the vowels.
Right. Right. Kevad hizkarnu et hadgashato בדבר ספר תהילים, שהוא מן השמיים, דברי אלוהים הם, למרות הסורות השונות שבכתבי הקודש. I think what he's saying here is, although you find in the Kitvei HaKodesh different uses of language, yes, the Yeshaya is different than Yirmiyah, it's different than Habakkuk, etc. And that would perhaps suggest otherwise, that no, it's not Mi'el Echad, no. The answer is, Shehu min ha-shamayim divrei Elohim hem, lamrot ha-surot ha-shonot shebi Kitvei HaKodesh. Yes?
And again, this follows the same idea because the mind of the people at the time of Tehilim is different than the mind of the people in the Midbar.
Right.
And therefore the language is processed, the language of the first person is always processed by the second person.
Right.
This also goes called the Nokeah.
Right, and this also and this is related to what you said a few minutes ago, that when you have a speaker, a first person, you need to have a second person. And therefore, the first person has to accommodate his language to the mind.
Not more than this, according to Jewish law. I said something, first person said something, and it was understood by the second person. First person said in his mind A, and the second person understood that this is B, the halacha is like B, for the name Amonot, and also, why did you said A? I don't care why you this. The A in our society is understood as B.
Right.
Don't tell me what you had in mind.
Right.
The same thing is in every business, you make a deal and you said X, and in your mind X meant I, A, but in my mind meant, in the mind of the public means B. So right. Therefore, X means B.
Right. Yes. Yesh devarim hamuvaim bilshon erev medaber. Sometimes you have as a slave speaking.
But
Hanan, but Hanan,
Moshe Rabbeinu.
Or Hanan, Hanan, Hanan. Yes. And you have another medaber el Abdo. Quiet. That's an Adon speaking to a slave and say that. Lo istapek. שהשעה פסוקים מכל כתבי הקודש כולם דברי אלוהים אם כי מקצתם מובאים בלשון אלוהים ומקצתם בלשון נביאות. And notwithstanding the fact that sometimes the words seem to come from Hashem directly, right? And sometimes the words seem to come from the Navi. So you might say, well, what seems to come from Hashem, that's from Hashem. And maybe what seems to come from Yeshaya speaking or Yirmiyah speaking, no, that's like Adonai, Uzi, Uma, Uzi, Umnusi, Beyom, Sara, that's Yirmiyah speaking. Maybe that's not from Hashem. No, they're both from Hashem. Umehem bilshon ha'am, and sometimes you have the people speaking. Veram pasu kemo, lo vabaha libi, veloram einai. Him, Devar Elohim, even that pasuk where a person speaking about himself, I didn't become arrogant and my eyes were not haughty. This also is Devar Elohim. Besura shesamam befi David. This is how Hashem put the words in the mouth of David. Umatarato lehorotenu umisvahi al yigbehu libotechem ve'al toramna einechem. And the purpose of Hashem putting these words in the mouth of David is to teach us the mitzvah that a person should not be haughty; he should be humble in the presence of Hashem. V'chein ha'tefila zechor Adonai leDavid et kol umnoto asher nishba Adonai nadar leAbid Yaakov. That also is from Hashem. V'chol ha'inyan chozrim leDibrei Elohim haroseh liyodi'am is kol lechol oseh tov et kol amalo umnoto. And Hashem, by putting these words in the mouth of David, wanted to teach us that yes, if somebody did good and toiled and suffered and fulfilled his shibuot and fulfilled his nadim, yes, I will remember it. So by Hashem inspiring David in Ruach HaKodesh to say these words, the purpose of that inspiration was to teach a lesson.
I have it a little bit different.
Okay.
You said about inspiring.
Right.
Yes. But, you know, Also, Balak spoke in the Torah.
Yes.
And if the Hamor spoke, the Aton spoke. So if one letter of this Aton is missing in the Sefer Torah Pasol.
Yes.
What makes the Sefer Torah Sefer Torah is that Borei Olam, when the Olam repeats this to Moshe Rabbeinu, is the repetition of the Torah. It's not the origin. Paro says. Who cares about Paro? But the fact that Borei Olam repeats it and gives it to Moshe, that transmission is what makes. You know, it's supposed a theory. I heard what Paro said to Moshe Rabbeinu, and on the basis of this, I want to do something. And still, Moshe did not give the Torah to Moshe Rabbeinu. I don't think it has a law. I don't think it has any Kedusha whatsoever.
Right.
It's the fact that Borei Olam wrote it down and it was published. How was it published? Right. Deposited in the Aron HaKodesh.
Right.
In the Aron, you know, the next of that. That is, that, and that was what I insist is the publication of the Torah. It's no longer, once that is published,
right.
It's no longer the words of Isaiah or the words, yes. Words of Bilam. Right. I, Bilam said this. The Aton said this.
Right.
Yes? Lama Ekitani. Right. Yes? So you bring a Raya from the words of the Aton.
Right.
It's not from the words of the Aton. Once that is published, it becomes Kadosh by the virtue of being published.
Right.
It's published by depositing it in the Aron next to in the Kodesh HaKodeshim.
Right, so for example, when Korach says, Ki chol ha'edah kulam kedoshim utocham Adonai, umadu titnaseu al kehal Adonai. It's not necessary, or he was not inspired by the Ruach HaKodesh to say those words, of course, but the fact that Moshe Rabbeinu was given that account of the story,
and was deposited in the Aron HaKodesh, right. That is what made it. This is an interesting machlok that I heard between Hacham Rabbi Yosef Misas and Hacham and Rabbi Adi Yosef. What kind of a tefillin Moshe Rabbeinu wore?
Right.
Two parashiyot or four parashiyot.
Right.
So first of all, it's
Right. Right.
Yes. But I believe that the Torah becomes this Torah should be taught, so it becomes this. You need a publication.
Right.
You need a publication.
Right.
You know? And so if Moshe Rabbeinu published it in the Mishkan, you know, as A is B, as A, as B is B.
Right. Okay. Let's continue. We were discussing the.
That something becomes Kadosh, becomes Torah. Torah Shebichtav. Yes, we don't look at the Torah as well, by the fact that the word deposited
in the
Aron. Right. And therefore, publication is part of Torah Shebichtav.
Right.
It's not Torah Shebichtav until it is published.
Right.
Yes? And therefore, I believe that there were different levels of publication in the Beit HaMikdash. Torah was in the Aron HaKodesh next to Luchot HaBedim. Then there was the Nevi'im in the archives of the Beit HaMikdash. And then there was different kinds of Torah, except for the Ketuvim. Probably they were published at a different epoch. I don't know. Yes, mm-hmm. But I believe that the Nevi'im were published at the beginning of the Bait Sheni, yes, or maybe at the end of Bait Rishon, but probably I believe at the beginning of Bait Sheni by Isaiah and Nehemiah in the Knesset Agerra, and then probably the Ketuvim they were after, and the Migrat and the Hamis Megillot was, you know, maybe at the very end, was, you know, right before the Churban Beit HaMikdash or something like this.
Right.
You know, so therefore. And the status of these books. Yeah. What about the book Fantastic Phenomenal written by I don't know this? Yeah, very nice, but it was not published in the Beit HaMikdash.
Right.
I explained what does it mean Kitvei HaKodesh? That they were in the Kodesh.
Right.
They were deposited in the Kodesh.
Right.
What happened with the other book which is so fantastic? Well, but it's not Kitvei HaKodesh.
Right.
You know, that's the simple as this. Yes. Yeah.
Or another pasuk. Choneni Elohim kechasdecha, kavanato. Lehodia. So again, it doesn't seem like these are words that come from Hashem. It looks like it comes from a word that comes from a person praying, which of course they are. Kavanato Lehodia. Yet the person was uttering these words, and eventually it was accepted as part of the Kitvei HaKodesh to teach us the lesson Shehu Soleach Lechol Shav. Right, that in fact Hashem does this type of chesed.
If I may make a digression here,
yeah.
Honneni. What does it mean exactly, Honneni? Because that question is very important, because we say that Adonai Erachum v'Hanun. So Hanun means that he has the fact to be Honen.
Right.
And we say this three times a day, Atah Honen. Yeah, that. What does it mean, Honen?
Right.
And I think the ultimate grace of Borei Olam is when he makes us understand why. Honeni means make me understand. I don't understand this. He's doing something for us and we don't understand why. So the ultimate Hanina is when you understand what you do, what's happening to you, why this is happening to me.
Very nice.
You understand? So this has to do, the ultimate Hanina is when Borei Olam makes you understand what's going on with you.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Right. וכדוגמת המשל הזה, הרי כל הספר תהילים, מה שיש בו, עם סיווי, או איסור, הבטחה, והזהרה, סיפור על העבר, או מה שעתיד להיות, whatever is in ספר תהילים, whether it's to instruct us to do this, or to forbid us from doing such, whether it is a promise for those who do good, or a warning to those who do bad, whether it's expressing a tale of the past, like Abraham Avinu with Melchizedek, in the end of the book of Tehilim, or what's going to happen in the future, Ya'alizu Hasini Mechavod, Yiraninu Mishkavotam, all of these things. Tefillah, Techina, Tefillah Le'aniki Ya'atov, right? Tochecha v'chol adome lahem kulam dibre Elohim hem. Irrespective of the content, all of these are in fact words given by, given in Ruach HaKodesh, which were, as we said, deposited in the
Ark.
Right. So all of it was in Ruach HaKodesh, exactly.
Yeah, but may I say something?
Yes.
To my mind.
Right.
Now, for instance, Tehillim.
Right.
Many of these Mizmorim, or most of them, or I believe all of them,
yeah,
they were set in the Beit HaMikdash.
Right.
Now, all of a sudden, you find in Dead Sea Scroll that this word is written with an Aleph or without an Aleph.
Right.
And you make a whole drasha out of that.
Right.
But the point is, what the words of Tehillim is not what actually was uttered by the Levi, but how it was published.
Mm-hmm.
Don't read me from this thing. First of all, maybe it's right, maybe it's wrong. I don't know. But even if it be somebody they had a tape recorder and taped the Levi that said it and pronounced the Aleph.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That is not the way it was recorded. It was recorded without an Aleph.
Right.
And all these things and all these dreams, you know, Loma Alev Loma Ri. Because
right,
this, what gives it the status of Kedusha is the publication is Kitve HaKodesh.
Right.
They are in the Kodesh. How? Where they were put in the Kodesh.
Right.
We have to one of the greatest Makot given on Am Yisrael is biblical criticism.
Right.
This is Kitve HaKodesh. We don't care what your theory of literature is. What is important is Kitve HaKodesh. This is the way it was the passage in the Beit HaMikdash.
Right.
So don't tell me what you find in the Dead Sea Scrolls. So what?
Right.
Well, I mean, in the Dead Sea Scrolls you find the U.S. Constitution written without this, doesn't mean anything.
Right. So for example, if you have, let's say, David HaMelech wrote the Book of Tehillim, for example. So he's recording things that happened. He's recording tefillot that he said. He's recording incidents, hatahot. So there's two sort of things here. there's a moment where he said the tefillah, and then there's a moment where he's recording it as a writing.
Yeah, well,
and
that counts. Am Yisrael, the Beit HaMikdash is recording right. this. Because ultimately, the Ketuvei HaKodesh, all the Ketuvei HaKodesh, from Bereshit Bara Elohim to the last word, word yeah. of the of Dibrei Hayamim, was deposited in the Beit HaMikdash. Mm-hmm. This is the way it was deposited in the Beit HaMikdash.
Right, and that's what actually, that's what ultimately counts.
Yeah, that's the only thing that counts.
We are not trying to go back in time and get an exact, precise, ontological reality of that moment.
I don't think nobody could do that.
Nobody could. Yeah. So similar to the U.S. Constitution, where let's say you had a discussion about freedom of speech.
Yeah.
That discussion is less important than the U.S. Constitution may say about
the most
speech.
Important thing I said this, I think, in one of my writers in the Shellfish or whatever it is. The Constitution that we have today, the deposit, is only a copy of the original Constitution. The original Constitution was lost. Mrs. Washington lost the Constitution on her way back. That's what she says. Yeah. All right? So we have only a copy of the Constitution.
Right.
So how do we know that this is what actually George Washington wanted to say? Kabbalah, suppose somebody in the Supreme Court would say, but I don't believe in this Kabbalah, they would be thrown out of court, the guy.
Right.
Well, I think that there was a mistake in the Constitution, and what is a mistake in the Constitution? Out.
Right.
You see? So the ultimate status of this is what is deposited in the Beit HaMikdash. That's the all.
Right. Shalem Adam, Shehakom Elohim, Shenetanam, Derachim Shonot, Shehen Derech Leshon Bene Adam. I'm sorry. And Besefer Tehilim Me'uma Midibre Bnei HaAdam. Exactly. What was ultimately recorded, ultimately, is the word of Hashem, similar to Korach saying, Kichol Ha'alak Olam Kedoshim, that's the word of Hashem to Moshe Rabbeinu.
The same thing of the Adon.
Right. Yes. Gav Sefer
Mishle. Ki Ha'Shalosh Regalim. Ramad Ha'Shalosh Regalim. Ki Tani Shalosh Regalim. Ba'asim Tuvu Shalosh Regalim. That's what Hashem is saying.
Right.
Is an Adon who said this? Yeah, but now this word have a status of Ketuvei HaKodesh, but also something. That's the status of the Ketuvei HaKodesh.
Right. Gam Sefer Mishle, this is very, very interesting what he says about Mishle, who min ha-shamayim, of course. Hussrach HaKadosh Baruch Hu lichtov beze ha-inyan sefer. The purpose of Sefer Mishle, what does it teach us? This is a book, Beyad HaChacham Shlomo Ben David Alav HaShalom, which contains, which was written by Shlomo HaMelech, who was a Chacham. Legalot kevot hadevarim sheyakus bahem hateva. The purpose of this is a wise man looking at the certain order in the world and showing that if you behave improperly, just as a matter of the way the world is designed and structured, your improper behavior will bring about certain bad consequences.
In other words, God puts in front of us. Is that very narrow? Is that you are fabricating your own things?
Right.
There is a cause and effect here. So therefore is the ra'ah, again, to save you from this concept, because I have bad luck. You didn't have bad luck. You behave wrongly.
Right.
You understand?
Yes. And that's why you need a hacham like Shlomo HaMelech, because you need a hacham to look at the world, understand the order, and see that there are certain things that a person needs to do in order to succeed, and certain things to avoid. Yeah. Don't sleep in too much, don't eat too much, be like the ant, like an imala
asem. And therefore, if something happens to the person, it's not because ra'aneget penechem.
Right.
Ra'aneget penechem is, this is going to happen to you.
Right.
You know?
Yes.
It's not ra'aneget penechem.
Right.
It's you did this, you know?
Right. To praise those who follow in the correct ways of Chokhmah. Ve'yakaram, how precious it is. So the content is a Chacham speaking to his pupil.
Educated. Kedesh Yarus HaChacham means to educate.
Right. But the fact is, even though the content is a Chacham speaking, and you would say, well, that's not Ruach HaKodesh. No. Well, it was written. It was written.
If the word of the Aton.
Exactly.
That's the point. The Aton, this word, if you're missing one aleph of this, of the word Aton, the Sefer Torah is Masur.
Exactly. So okay, this is the word of Shalom HaMelech. As it was recorded in Mishle, that's the Ruach HaKodesh, that's the Kitvei HaKodesh.
I want to tell you something in connection to this. How do we know? It's a fantastic thing. And I wrote it in my Bayan Yosef. How do we know what is written in Mishle? Mm-hmm. 1 second, or in any Pasuk. So, suppose there is a Machloket, and this I make a Pesach like a Rambam, between the Hachamim in Babel made a Derasha based upon an Aleph. And in the Keter Amshavah, this word is written Aleph. Should I write the Sefer Torah according to the way that the Rasha is made in the Talmud? Or should make no. But in the Keter Amshavah is written Aleph. What should we do? Rambam Keter Amshavah. And now here is very important. The Torah Shebichtav was transmitted to us by the Kohanim, the Beit HaMikdash, Leviim, and Chachmei HaMisorah.
Right.
Alright? Just like the Torah Shebe'alpeh was transmitted to us by Rabbi Nami Rav Hashem, ultimately, the Torah Shebichtav was through the Beit HaMikdash.
Right.
It's very, very important, this point. And if there's a machloket on the ketiv of the Torah Shebichtav between Chachmei HaMisorah and Talmud Bavli, halakha is like the Mishra.
Right.
Alright?
Right.
Yeah. So take the telephone and throw it.
Right. Okay. Let's continue because we only have a few minutes left on the camera. So let's finish it. Now what about Iyov? So we have Tehilim, we have Mishle, what about Iyov? The purpose of the book is to teach us a certain
mode of thinking,
the different theories about the divine providence in this world.
That the four arguments, the things A plus Y, they were wrong because they assume, that's my theory, Kira'a Neged Pnechem.
Right.
And Kam Moshe, Kashwachu says, no, it's not because of Kira'a Neged Pnechem.
Right.
It's because you made a bulbul.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
And why God at the end gave all these things to Yob? Because you think the purpose of the Torah is to enjoy life? Double pizza for you, all right? Double pizza, and then goodbye, yo. You know, whatever it is, you know. So I understand that the four opinions mentioned there, yes, with the exception of Elihu, it says about Haskaha Pirati, the four theories, the three friends, plus yo, is an evaluation of Kira'a Neged Pnechem.
Right. The Ulam, Baru Ladaba, Shegam Hu Min HaShamayim. Even though it's bringing these incorrect theories, it's also Min HaShamayim.
To learn!
Al Pi Mishpatim Acherim. Ve'el Yitbarach Rasham Lanu B'Sefer, for a moment, B'Sefer Iyov, Nisayon Echad HaSadikim. It tells us the story of a Sadiq who underwent the Nisayon, Hashem Nisa Oto. Vehu Sabar et Nisayon. He suffered the Nisayon. Vehu Iyov Navi Alav Shalom. Vehakadosh Baruch Hu Itallah Katav Lanu Hagadatam Vesam Otam Lanu Lemashal. Leman Nikach Mehem Musav Netaken Aspen. Whatever the Musav is and whatever the Tikkun is. But this is the part that I found fascinating. Because everybody always talks about Shira Shirim. I never heard this explanation of Shir HaShirim. This to me is fascinating. The Shir HaShirim, who Ashir Hazeh, who Tefillat HaMalachim. We always speak about the Shevach of the Malachim and the Chayot HaKodesh. Shir HaShirim is that Tefillah. Uchshe Melech שלמה, וכשמלך שלמה וישב על כיסו, הוא בא בשיר השירים, שהוא תפילת המלאכים. הוא מבאר איפה, למה נתן ספר תהילים דווקא בזמנו של דוד. ספר זה בגלל הדרת ערכו, ומשום שהוא דברי אלוהים מחולקים, בדרכי ההבעה השונים, שבשום ספר אין למסור את כל דרכי ההבעה האנושית שבהם אפשר למסור לו לאדם, להביע רחשיו. So that's the purpose of Tehillim, that you can express many, many different human beings, many different emotions, many different situations. וכל דרכי ההבעה שדרכם אפשר להשפיע על האדם. לכן הורידו אלוהים, אלא בזמן שהייתה האומה בתכלית שלמות המסב ושלמות העניין. And that's why it was given to the Am Yisrael at a time of David HaMelech, when it really truly was a time of perfection, meaning we were going towards that moment of perfection, where we would have the Bet HaMikdash, the political access, the access of the Kehunah, the access of the Sanhedrin, and that's why Sefer Shir HaShirim was given. Sefer Shir HaShirim, שהוא שירת המלאכים, ולכן נתן ניתן בשעה שישראל הגיעו לרוב המעלות. היינו בזמן שלמה. It was only in the days of Shlomo HaMelech, where finally the bayit was shalem, the kiseh was shalem, that we were able to have access to understand the shirah of the malachim. It's in that context that...
How is it shirah of malachim?
Because we know that the bayit rishon, when the Bet HaMikdash was built, inside the Bet HaMikdash, you have
absolutely yes
the malachim and the chayot hakodesh and the keruvim. Shlomo HaMelech, he had access to this. I mean, the proof of the thing is that he put his own keruvim and he changed the midot of many things. Mm-hmm. So he understood certain things about the world of the malachim. Mm-hmm. So he was in that world.
Just I wanted to say,
right.
Newton, and it should be studied, has several books written about the fantastic mathematics in the building of the Bet HaMikdash.
Right.
So Newton understood that the Bet HaMikdash is not just an architecture
right.
thing, but it's secrets of mathematics.
Right, and I think that only somebody who had access to the world of the Malachim would be able to design the Bet HaMikdash.
But I think that it's something else. Why, if the Shir HaShirim is a metaphor involving Malachim, I would like to have an example.
ששים ושמחים לעשות רצון קונם, קונהם, ששים ושמחים לעשות רצון קונם, ששים ושמחים. That this is a joy, רסים לעשות את זה, that מושכני אחריך נרוסה. This explains the enthusiasm of the מלאכים in אחרת הקודש in fulfilling the order of Hashem. Only the מלאכים at this level.
I think that it needs...
Okay. But it's a fascinating thing.
Yeah.
And the point is that Shlomo, at the height of his kingdom, when he was young, not later, because later...
No. I have a positive... At the beginning, I had... I believe that Shlomo HaMelech realized that it cannot be built Bet HaMikdash unless there is peace. And for this, he married this 1,000 women.
Right, right. And truly it worked. The Tanach is me'i that there was in fact peace. And that there was tremendous prosperity.
And if you don't have peace, you cannot build Bet HaMikdash.
Right.
So therefore he is... But also I have another theory. It's a horrible theory. That since he was able to create Cherim, that the people fulfilling the happiness of this southern world, all the women, were Cherim manufactured by Shlomo HaMelech,
mm-hmm.
his own slaves or something like that. None of these women know how to distinguish between the physiognomy of Shlomo HaMelech, you know. So I would not pass it that these women were involved with which Shedim created, and the Shedim could be also biological Shedim, yes, and so on. So how a woman knows whether this is a Shed is or is not Shlomo HaMelech.
Right.
Yeah, maybe Yamin, yes.
Okay, so then, and now we're finishing. Ve'lachen nitan b'sha'a sh'Yisrael higiu l'rov ha'ma'alot. Haino, bizman Shlomo. And why did they reach Rav HaMa'alot? He has a beautiful derasha here. Sheme Avraham le'ad Shlomo yeshna aleha 15 dorot. Le'umat 15 yom arishonim la'yareach. Israel Mishulim LaLevana. So the moon has a 30-day cycle where it's empty and then it becomes brighter and brighter and brighter. The 15th day, of course, which is two, which is the day of Pesach, which is the day of Sukkot, it's the brightest, and then it goes down. So from Avraham Avinu to Shlomo HaMelech, 15 generations. So that was the point where we were able to hear the singing of the Malachim, and hence we have the book of Shir HaShirim. And then we have the down part. Mikan ve'ad Sidkiyahu shuv 15 dorot. And then from Shlomo HaMelech to Sidkiyahu, you have another 15 generations. Uzeman yeridata. Uchshemalach Shlomo. וכשמלך שלמה שהיה גדול בכל מלכי ישראל ויותר חכם מכל אדם וכשמלך שלמה וישב על כיסאו ובא בשיר השירים שהוא שירת המלאכים עד כאן. So this is, I thought it was a very, very, very interesting סעדי הגאון, because everybody always compares שיר השירים to some love song. I was never like, what do we need, love songs. Right. So I think this is a fascinating entry, and it makes a lot of sense to me, because the pathos and the ethos in Shir HaShirim makes sense in the context of Malachim, who understand Hashem, and not in
other contexts. I understand of Shlomo HaMelech is that he was not involved with these women.
Right.
That's a, that says it took them a war, whatever it is, but, you know, this thing. Just I want to ask you, where did this come from? When it says,
okay, Yosef Yoel Rivlin, Hakdamat Rasag, Dav Shin Peh. Hakdamat Rasag, Dav Shin Peh.
There must be something else. But anyway, I will lay down when you're home, find out where this comes from. The Yosef Rivlin was from the Tse'esae, Tamidav Shetobyaki, Eshelobyaki, 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 you know.
Right, it's the name of the book is Ta'amei HaMisvot Mirabenu Menachem HaBavli Zal Merasag Zal, meaning Rabenu Menachem HaBavli is quoting Rabbi.
Yeah, so later on you give me this, because I'll ask the school to give me.
That'll be interesting to see that, right. So that's why some of it was Atkan, because then the Rabenu Menachem is commenting on the Rabenu Sa'adiyah Gaon. I should have made that more clear. This is why we were reading it. We were reading Rabenu Menachem quoting Rabenu Sa'adiyah Gaon. Some parts of it were quote and parts of it Rabenu Menachem. But their purpose I like, what I liked here was the part about Shir HaShirim. That's what I found to be fascinating.
Beautiful. Thank you very much.
So then, and now we're finishing. V'lachen nitan b'sha'a sh'Yisrael higiyu l'rov ha-ma'alot. Haino, b'zman Shlomo. And why did they reach l'rov ha-ma'alot? He has a beautiful derasha here. Sh'me Avraham l'ad Shlomo, yeshna aleha 15 dorot. 15 dorot. לעומת 15 יום הראשונים לירח. ישראל משולים ללבנה. So the moon has a 30-day cycle where it's empty and then it becomes brighter and brighter and brighter. The 15th day, of course, which is two, which is the day of Pesach, which is the day of Sukkot, it's the brightest, and then it goes down. So from Avraham Avinu to Shlomo HaMelech, 15 generations. So that was the point where we were able to hear the singing of the Malachim, and hence we have the book of Shir HaShirim. And then we have the down part. Mikan ve'ad Sidkiyahu shuv 15 dorot. And then from Shlomo HaMelech to Sidkiyahu, you have another 15 generations. Uzeman yeridata. Uchshemalach Shlomo, uchshemelech Shlomo shehaya gadol bechol malchei Yisrael, ve'yoter chacham mikol adam. Uchshemalach Shlomo ve'yashav al kiso ova b'shir ha'shirim shehu shirat ha'malachim ad kan. So this is, I thought it was a very, very, very interesting Sa'adiyah Gaon, because everybody always compares Shir HaShirim to some love song.
What do we need, love songs.
Right. So I think this is a fascinating entry, and it makes a lot of sense to me, because the pathos and the ethos in Shir HaShirim makes sense in the context of Malachim, who understand Hashem, and not in other
contexts. I understand of Shlomo HaMelech is that he was not involved with these women.
Right.
That's took them a war, whatever it is, but, you know, this thing. Just I want to ask you, where did this come from? When it says...
Okay. Yosef Yoel Rivlin, Hakdamat Rasag, Dav Shin Peh. Hakdamat Rasag, Davshin Pehe.
There must be something else. But anyway, I will lay down in your home, find out where this comes from. The Sefriblim is was from the Sa'e, Talmidav Shel Rabbi Akiva, Shel Rabbi Akiva, Shel Rabbi Yaumir, you know.
Right, it's the name of the book is Ta'ameh Misvot Mirabenu Menachem HaBavli Zal Merasag Zal, meaning Rabbenu Menachem HaBavli is quoting the book.
Yeah, so later on you give me this because I'll ask the school to give me.
That'll be interesting to see that, right. So that's why some of it was Atkan, because then the Rabbenu Menachem is commenting on the Rabbenu Sa'adiyah Gaon. I should have made that more clear. This is what we were reading it. We were reading Rabbenu Menachem quoting Rabbenu Sa'adiyah Gaon. Some parts of it were quote and parts of it Rabbenu Menachem. But their purpose that I like, what I liked here was the part about Shira Shirim. That's what I found to be fascinating.
Thank you very much.